Welcome to Hopping Chef and you are with Chef Shantanu. The next recipe that I'm going to show is purely dedicated to my mom. You know, we as Maharashtrians have a very typical recipe which is made out of boiled chana daal called Bengal gram and it's called Puran Poli. How? Just find out. So I've got boiled chana daal here and I've got gud or jaggery, local Indian sugar. So I'm going to take equal quantities of the jaggery and the puran or the boiled Bengal gram and keep it for heating. So approximately equal quantities of the jaggery and I have to keep on stirring it because if I don't, it might stick to the pan. So let's start stirring it. Now a trick here, if you want it to dissolve slightly quickly, just add just a little bit of milk. So what happens now is, along with the milk, the jaggery melts a little quicker. Again, you have to be very careful while doing this. This is exactly like sugar. By chance, if I put my finger in or have the splitter on my finger, and it's going to have a really bad burn. So once the jaggery is melted, take it off the heat slightly. Time to add equal amount of the boiled, almost mashed up chana daal to this. And once again, back to the heat. Break it as much as possible. If you have a potato masher, you can use that as well. Makes life slightly easier. You keep on cooking it, keep it on the side. If your spoon stands into this, which means the puran, which is the mixture, is cooked to the right consistency. But I like a little bit grains coming into your mouth while you're eating it. So I'll leave it to this stage. Let's put this off. To this, the main flavor that I'm going to add is some cardamom, elaichi as it's called locally. So cardamom to this. Once again, mix it up. As you can see, once it's off the heat, it will start thickening more. But it's still fairly hot to handle. Take it out on a flat platter or a plate. Spread it up nicely. Once you want it further cool, you can put it in the fridge. So next what I'm going to do is I'm going to make pancakes. Now if my mom had done it or if my grandmother had done it, what they do is they have this puran cold enough. They make a dough out of whole wheat flour and then they stuff this puran inside, make it into a chapatti, a flatbread, and then cook it on the pan. That's the traditional way how they do it. We are going to do it slightly different, as I said. So I'm going to make a pancake batter. So we have got the Indian style puran and the Western style pancake. So 1 to 2 eggs, approximately 100 to 120 grams of refined flour, Maida, but you can of course use whole wheat flour as well. Okay, that's around 100 to 120 grams of the flour. I'm going to add a little bit of the milk and just a pinch of salt. That's always my style. So with this, mix it through. We don't want a batter that is too thick and won't spread on the pan. So just keep on adding milk, but you need to add some baking powder to this. So now this is the right consistency. If I mix a spoon into this, see, it's lightly coating the spoon. It's not a heavy coating. You can see the spoon, but it is still coating the spoon. So that's the consistency that I was looking at. And here, as I said, I got my clarified butter or ghee, just adding it to the mix. Now, why do we do this? It helps to add taste as well as it prevents the batter from sticking to the pan. In the meanwhile, I've got some oil here which has been heating. See, I've not stuffed rotis like they do traditionally, but I've got a plain chapati here. So what I'm going to do with this chapati is roll it and just make thin julienne. And once my oil is hot, I'm going to deep fry this chapati. This pan is heating up. And this is how I was taught to check it. You get it close to your face. If you can feel the heat on your ears, which means the pan is hot enough. If you can feel a lot of heat, it's bad, because then by the time you pour the batter, it's going to go and stick to the pan and not come out. It's not going to spread. So heat it just enough that you feel the heat. It should not be too cold, not very hot. This is right at the moment. So again, let me add a little bit ghee to this. Just mere ghee. Especially when you're doing the first pancake, this is very important, because normally when you make the first pancake in a new batch, it tends to stick to the pan. So especially for the first one, take a coating of the ghee. So now let me take a good amount of batter in the center and quickly spread it off as much as possible. So this is good enough. Now it will start first cooking on the sides, and as it cooks up, it will cook the center. As you can see, the edges have started crisping up a little and the pancake is off. Quickly on the other side, not too much, and out. Let's check if the oil is hot now. Yes, it is. So back to my julienne of chapatti for frying, and the chapattis that I had put for frying is ready here. While it is still hot, I'm taking some nice icing sugar and sprinkling it all over so it gets sweetened up as well. So that's my garnish. So I've got three cooked pancakes and my puran mixture, the mixture of my chana daal and jaggery, was cooling. Let me get that first. So my puran mixture is now ready here. The pancakes are ready. We serve a traditional coconut cream or a coconut milk with the puran polis and clarified butter. So that's what I'm going to do here, again with a slight twist. So we have got some clarified butter inside this, some coconut milk. I'm adding some maple syrup. So let this heat up slightly once again. Now this is one dish that you can serve either at room temperature or you can serve warm. I like it when it's warm. So that's how I'm serving it. You can have it the way you like it. Let's mix this. So let this thicken up a bit on low heat. In the meanwhile, let me have my puran mix laid out in a row. Now literally like a roll, tighten it up. This is almost getting ready. As I said, as the coconut milk cooks. So let me take a nice clean plate out here. Let's trim the edges off. Along the length, let me give a slit on the tangent. Icing sugar. This on top, smothered slightly around. You know, everything else is very soft and succulent. The pancake is soft, the puran is soft. So this crispies are going to add a new dimension to this puran poli. Icing sugar that I have. Amazing part of this dish. Just smear it around. Let me take a little bit of the real maple syrup. Just a little mint on top. Here's what we've got. Cultural Indian puran poli. Not from India, but as if it's made on Mars. Lovely. Try it. Something different. Add a new dimension to the recipes that you make. How long you're going to make the same typical stuff. Try something new, as we have done it. But if you have to know more new recipes, please subscribe to our channel.